Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 3.22 of the textbook First Course in Probability. So in this problem, we roll three dice simultaneously. We assume that those three dice have three different colors. They are red, blue, and yellow. And the goal is to compute the probability that the value of the blue die is strictly less than the value of the yellow die and strictly less itself than the value of the red die. So you have a couple of questions to eventually get the answer. Instead of following the book and all those different steps, I'm going to kind of motivate the idea behind the conditioning. Basically, what the book tells you is answering some question to lead you to the answer. I'm going to instead tell you about why indeed that makes sense to kind of follow this pattern. So I'm going to write here the event that we want to, the probability that we want to compute. So that's the probability of event A that we said blue is strictly less than yellow and strictly less than red. Okay, so we want to compute the probability of this event. And so now a natural observation is just to say that, well, we want, I mean, on this event A, we have a specific ordering of the three values of the die, the dice. And so clearly, if two of the three dice at least land on the same value, then this is not possible. Okay? And at the same time, if this happens, at least two of the dice land on the same value, then there is no strict ordering. And so what you want to do intuitively, you know, that explains why the author is asking us to solve like those two preliminary questions. What makes sense is to condition, to compute the probability of A, is to condition on another event that is the event that all three dice are going to land on three different values, okay? And indeed, if this event occurs, then you can indeed look at the probability of this specific ordering, because there will be a specific ordering of the three dice if the three values are different. And on the complement of this event, then this event cannot happen. So clearly, if you know whether the dice land on three different values or not, that really helps to solve the problem. So that explains like the motivation of introducing this other event. So I'm going to call the event B that all three dice land on different values. So all three dice land on different values. Okay, and so again, the motivation is, well, it turns out that P of B is much easier to compute than P of A, okay? And it turns out also that if you know B, then that tells you that there is indeed a strict ordering of those three colors, and P of A given B is also easy to compute. Now, what about P of A given B complement? Well, that's even easier. Given B complement, that means that two of the dice land on the same value. That cannot happen. So P of A given B complement should be equal to zero. Okay, so that was kind of to motivate the first two questions of the problem. Now I'm going to answer the last question directly. So, but also answering at the same time the first two questions, in fact. So now we can say that P of A is equal to, I'm going to condition on a partition to compute P of A. The partition I'm going to use is B and B complement, just those two events. In fact, it's enough to just condition on B because A is in fact a sub-event of B, but I'm going to write the whole thing so that you see what happens. So it's P of A given B times P of B plus P of A given B complement times P of B complement. Okay? Then P of A given B complement, like we just said, it's equal to zero. Indeed, if B does not occur, that means that at least two dice land on the same value. So you cannot have a strict inequality among the three values. So that means that this is just zero. So we can ignore this second part here. And then, what about this here? So I'm going to write P of B first. That's a little bit easier. So what is the probability of B? Well, you look at the total number of ways you can choose a value for blue, yellow, and red. You have six possibilities for blue, okay? So that all three values are different. You have six possibilities for blue, but then only five left for yellow, because that cannot be the same value as blue, and only four left for red, because that cannot be the same value as blue and yellow. So that tells you that the total number of outcomes, if you roll your three dice, so that the three values are different, is exactly 6 times 5 times 4. And then you need to divide that by size of the sample space. That's exactly all the possible values that those three dice can take. So you have 6 for each of them. You have 3 dice, so that's going to give you a 6 cube. So 6 cube here. So this number here, so it's basically, you simplify by 6, it's just 20 divided by 36, is exactly the probability that all three values are going to be different. Now, what about the probability of A given B? That's the probability of this ordering of the dice, given that you indeed have three different values. Okay, so here, the trick is, there is no fancy calculation to find that, but that's a little bit tricky maybe at first to understand things that way. It's really to say that on the event B, given the event B, you have indeed three different values. So that means that you can indeed order the three dice. There is a strict ordering of the three values. And then, it's just to say that, well, because of perfect symmetry, so what I'm using here is basically a symmetry argument, that's something very common in probability theory. We don't need to really count everything that can happen, all the possible outcomes. The idea is really to say that by symmetry, any of the ordering of the three dice are going to be equally likely. So instead of looking at all the possible values that the dice can take on the even B and looking at the subset such that we have this ordering, I'm going to, instead of looking at the values, I'm just thinking in terms of ordering. And I just say, well, we have three dice. So looking at possible permutations of the value, that gives you three factorial possible permutation of the values of the three dice, okay? But by symmetry, because all three dice are fair dice and they land on independent values, then the probability of this specific ordering, given that we have indeed one of the three factorial ordering, should be equal to 1 divided by 3 factorial. The 1 divided by 3 factorial, so that's the probability of A given B. So here we have a 1 divided by 3 factorial, comes from the fact that there, given the even B that you have three different values, we can indeed order the three dice. There are three factorial possible orderings of the three dice. Those orderings should be equally likely. So the probability of this conditional probability should be equal to the number of orderings such that this is satisfied divided by the total number of orderings, 3 factorial, but obviously this is one specific ordering, so it's 1 out of 6 possible orderings of the 3 dice. Okay? And so eventually that's the answer. You get that number. You can in fact write this. I mean, you can simplify that yourself. It's a 20 divided by 36. You need to divide by another 6 and so on. And so eventually, after simplification, you find 5 over 54. Okay? And using a calculator, you would see that this is about equal to 0.09259.